All right, we're going to start out slow. Get comfortable throwing your basic set of strikes, and then you have to show me how well you can defend yourself. Let's throw a few jabs. Let's go. Yep, that's right. Push off on your back leg. Very important. Jabs are great to set your opponent up for a more powerful punch. Like a cross. Now, lead with the jab and follow with a couple of bell-ringing hooks. Ding, ding, ding. All right, now set up the uppercut with a jab. Listen, nobody does that, so you might trick him. And you never know, you might just put your opponent to bed. Get ready. Next, we're going to work on some stamina drills. Now go ahead and start off by throwing as many punches as you can until I feel your gassed. Wow, this is like watching you under a heavy blanket. Stop going in slow motion. Perfect. Now move around a little bit and throw some more heavy punches. Don't waste my time now. That's not it. Try again. You're setting a great example with that kind of effort, and you're also earning respect. Let's do this. Now that you know how damaging low stamina can be, it's time to steal some from your opponent. So let's throw some body shots. Good. Now body shots don't show tons of damage, but they will drain all the energy and spirit out of a fighter. Go ahead, throw a body combo, and you want to finish it up with a liver shot. It's time to start the drill. Are you ready to start the exercise? Keep pushing yourself, don't stop. Now, if you want to parry a shot, it will throw him off balance, and you can follow it up with a beautiful counter. If he's throwing his left, you want to parry it to the left. And if he's doing it right, you want to do it right. Okay, it looks like you got the basics done, which is good because, surprise, surprise, I have you booked for your first amateur fight. Don't be nervous, just focus on your stand-up right now. We'll get to the rest later. But if you want, we can spar a little bit. Thank you. Stand-up is only part of the mixed martial arts equation. You're also going to need to know how to handle yourself in a clinch. Good, let's do some clinch phases. Some clinches, some strikes. Easy enough. Now, throw some damaging knees and some slicing elbows at your opponent. Okay, now that you've done your damage, you want to get out of the clinch. That's nice. Find a rhythm. That's it. I wish everyone in this gym could do it like that. You really have it down. It's time to start the drill. We're going to start out the same way. Clinch up. Now, getting him against the cage is going to put you in a dominant position, and it will give you some different options. Now that he's against the cage, I want to sink your double underhooks in. Get both arms under his arm, but take him down. Now, a takedown from the double underhooks is going to set you up in a good position on the ground. If you want to take somebody down, a double underhook is a perfect way to set
it
up.
I want to see you clinch in your next fight, which, by the way, I've already scheduled for you.
Yep, that's right. Hey, listen, don't worry about going to the ground. These guys aren't at that level yet either. Do you want a little quick sparring session before we head out?